The biggest mystery of the new four-part true crime series, The Sons of Sam, from the director Joshua Zeman, has little to do with the infamous murders, in 1976 and 1977, of young people in New York City. Rather, it's a mystery that Zeman himself sets up, in his own voice, at the very start. In 2017, he says, he received boxes of materials related to the murders from a late investigative journalist, Maury Terry, who devoted much of his career to pursuing alternate theories of the murder case. Those materials, and Terry's quest, are the framework for Zeman's series. What the film leaves unresolved, to its detriment, is the relationship between Zeman and Terry that led Zeman to make his film in the first place. The entire movie plays like an effort to compensate for that absence, and turns what could have been a fascinatingly personal docuseries into a distractingly conventional, arm's-length one. To set up the story, Zeman summarizes the facts of the Son of Sam shootings, 8 attacks, from July, 1976, to July, 1977, in the Bronx, Queens, and Brooklyn, that targeted young couples, especially ones sitting together in cars, and also young women. As the movie makes clear, the killings terrified the city, all the more so because the attacker taunted the world with tangled and menacing letters in which he identified himself as the Son of Sam, and offered up a jumble of occult references to adorn his reign of terror. He was intensely conscious of his own public image, even taking care to address a letter directly to the New York Daily News columnist Jimmy Breslin, who sparked controversy, including in the pages of The New Yorker, by publishing portions of it. From the beginning, Zeman tells this story with an ardent sense of research that's packaged in an impersonally conventional format, a blend of original interviews, including with retired police officers, journalists who'd covered the case, and Terry's associates, archival news footage, photographs, newspaper clips, and other documents, all displayed through a floating and zooming camera that both forces the feeling of motion and turns substance into impressions. Nonetheless, Zeman captures a startling moment of revelation, an amazing detail of banal police work that cracked the case, in an interview with James Justice, a retired NYPD detective, who connected David Berkowitz, of Yonkers, to the attacks by means of a parking ticket. Berkowitz was arrested and confessed to all of the murders. He remains in prison to this day. But, as the movie makes clear, something in the news struck Terry, a former journalist, then working as an in-house writer for the research department of IBM, as inconsistent. He was troubled by apparent disparities between the composite sketches of the shooter, based on eyewitness accounts, and the appearance of Berkowitz. The NYPD.